Presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, Alpha Channel Enhancements in ProPresenter 7.14. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever been in a situation where you really wish you could do alpha channels, but you didn't have the budget, or you didn't have a free channel on a DeckLink Duo, or one of the other problems that could arise, go ahead, subscribe, ring the bell icon, and make a comment under the video, too, if you will. So, this is something that's going to be a game changer for some people. I was talking to someone earlier this week, actually right before they announced ProPresenter 7.14. I'm releasing this in YouTube much later, but for my Church Tech U members, releasing it right when I get done doing it. He was saying, so is Alpha Channel really necessary? We're a traditional church. And I just had to say, the only problem with doing alpha is the money involved. And I couldn't tell him then about one of these things that will potentially save him a lot of money. So let's head over to the computer and I'll show you exactly what I mean. So if we go to screens and configure screens right here, you'll notice a new tab here. This is an HDMI output, so it should not have the alpha tab, but it does. So how does that work? Well, if you click on here and you change alpha from none to either straight or pre-multiplied, then you saw my thing blink, because then what happens is, while I have the hardware for the regular fill signal, I need another piece of hardware for the key signal. So I can just change this output to, let's say, another HDMI. Hey there, aspiring ProPresenter Pro. Are you tired of getting tangled up in tech trouble? Want to impress your congregation with mind-blowing visuals? Well, look no further. Introducing ProPresenter 7 training at Church Tech U, your secret weapon for unlocking ProPresenter's full potential. Join me as I dive into the world of captivating presentations, smooth transitions, and jaw-dropping effects. From beginner basics to advanced tips and tricks, I've got you covered. Don't miss out on this amazing opportunity. Visit churchtechu.com/free trial for a free month now. Did I mention it's free? And revolutionize your ProPresenter game. Your congregation will thank you. Now, when I do this, it's going to squawk at me because, as it turns out, I already had that assigned to another output. But let me make sure that I'm remembering. Yeah, so that's one. So I'm going to assign this to number two right here. See, it says, wait, you're already using that. In this case, I'm just going to click reassign to new. So now we have the fill and we have the key, and those are both HDMI signals. So let me go ahead and real quick show you what those look like. So let's go down here and so put that up, and now let me show you this. So there is the fill signal, or the key signal rather. Let me bring that back down, and let me also, I'm going to have to hit a couple of buttons here. There show you that other signal, and that's the other signal. Had that on another display, so those are two signals, both in HDMI and both created in ProPresenter 7. Just that was me going back and forth between them, and now I can go back to ProPresenter 7 here, and that's good to go. Now I will need to go into my video switcher and change which two those are, but I could run it all without my DeckLink Duo now. I can just run it nice and simply from two HDMI ports. But I could also run it from one HDMI and one SDI. So the problem with this might be, though, if they are slightly different frame rates or if they're different resolutions. So make sure that is not the case. So that's pretty cool. Otherwise, there's also another selection here. Let's go to Configure Screens. And when I added that, you might have noticed that I had none, which is the default, straight, which is a new setting, and pre-multiplied, which was the former setting. So a good way to understand the difference between straight and pre-multiplied is if you have ever done alpha with cross-dissolve between slides, you might have noticed some kind of gray ghosting on the image. That's a result of the pre-multiplied key. But with the straight key, it won't do that anymore. So it's kind of a subtle change, and if you're doing cuts already and you're totally cool with that, you might not notice any difference whatsoever. But that's a new setting that they have added in 7.14. One thing that's worth mentioning is once you change that to straight from pre-multiplied, so if we go down here to my alpha output, I've changed that to from straight to pre-multiplied, but or from pre-multiplied to straight rather, I really need to get into the software of my ATEM Television Studio HD and tweak the settings to make sure that it's ideal. So that is something else that I'll need to do here to make that work. So that's the other thing. One thing that they mentioned during the announcement that's worth mentioning too is we've got the DeckLink Duo 2, we've got the Quad 2. There's a new card, newer than the Duo 2 and the Quad 2, which a lot of people were getting instead. Anytime that they were sold out of the Duo 2 or the Quad 2, they'd go with this other card. I'm blanking on what it is. But it wasn't as flexible. Well, now, with this setting, you could set individual outputs to be key and fill, and then you would have much more flexibility. So that's something that's cool as well. So that's all about the all new keying enhancements, the alpha keying enhancements in ProPresenter 7.14. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course. So head on over to tdm.fyi/pro, the number 7, and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.